the strong man stood waiting. She set the baby in the shade of the lilac that had become a skeleton, and then she ripped the scarecrow from his post. She held him by the stick that was both his backbone and his legs, and she marched him to the fire pit where she staked him into the ashy earth. It took only one match for the straw and cloth and wood to turn to fire. One brilliant flame followed by a black ghost of smoke.
Don't ever fall in love.
Once the ghost had agonized, Esther two herbs will fade a bit. They won't go change color as they dry away. Some flowers do just to prove they are indeed magic. Esther was once attracted to the flashiness of such plants, but now she prefers the simpler, quieter flowers. She follows the steps, arrange, squeeze together, hold tight and wrap, hold tight and tie, cut away excess string and begin again, bundle after bundle. The hanging is the last step, and this she does down in the cellar. More string, she keeps the scissors in her apron pocket, pins too. If she runs out of room down there, she hangs the vest in the old pink Cadillac she keeps on cinder blocks next to the rickety swing set with the bar her daughter Dahlia liked to hang from when she was still a girl. The bar from which Dahlia's own daughter Crystal then took to hang from as well. Esther remembers seeing Crystal hang from that bar for the first time. After all those years on the farm alone, and the way of Dahlia running she'd gotten confused. Time had collapsed and she thought it was Dahlia again, and she crept up on the child to see what she could see. It didn't take long to know it wasn't her daughter hanging there, but her granddaughter, and she remembered how Dahlia did eventually come back, and when she did, she had her own daughter. While Crystal and Dahlia resemble each other the way most mothers and daughters do, like most mothers and daughters, they also didn't. Don't ever fall in love. Back when she crept up on Dahlia, she'd find her daughter's eyes closed, eyeballs fluttering. Only when Dahlia opened her eyes, she'd stare deep into Esther like she could see every single one of her mother's thoughts and feelings. Neither one of them had ever much liked being all that close to the other, and the few times this had happened, they'd been even more aloof around each other afterward. But when Crystal hung upside down from that bar and Esther would come creeping up on her, the girl's eyes didn't just flutter. Eventually they'd open, only Crystal clearly couldn't see Esther standing there. It was likely she couldn't see anything, at least not in front of her, as her eyes would roll back into her head. The green iris swallowed entirely by the white globe of the other side of sea.
If she ran fast enough, she could sometimes reach the garden in time
catch George in her arms as he stepped down from his post, back into something light-bodied. And there